Greetings, it's Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand and author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the Candida Dietary Supplement Range. Thanks for checking out my video. We've been talking a bit about dysbiosis. Let's just go a bit further and look at what the signs and symptoms of dysbiosis are. There are many different kinds of signs and symptoms you could develop as a result of having, you know, an imbalanced gut flora. If we look at the more obvious ones, they're conditions that a lot of people I see have. Lots of patients in the clinic will complain to me of gas, lots of farting and bloating, pain, because when you've got what we call incarcerated flatulence or gas trapped inside, it can push on different parts of nerves internally and cause a bit of sharp pain here or there. So key areas that you want to look at for gut dysbiosis, you'll often find a bit of pain here or up here. You can get pockets of gas along the top of the bowel or down the side here. When you go to bed at night and you lie down, you might pass wind. That's quite common for healthy people. But when you're standing upright and passing wind when you're walking, you've got way too much gas production. Okay, you shouldn't be farting throughout the day. Some patients like fart all the time. They've got way too much gas production. That means that they're fermenting. Okay, they've got bad bacteria inside their gut. Healthy people pass a small amount of gas by default. People with gut dysbiosis can pass huge amounts of volumes of gas. So lots and lots of gas and bloating signifies gut dysbiosis. It's one of the common things that you'll find. Some people can develop nausea, a mild nausea, or a feeling, a sensation of being sick as well. Some people also can get more upper digestive problems, which can mean heartburn, reflux, or having a disordered appetite. Other people will tend to get more lower abdominal issues, including constipation and diarrhea, or IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. IBS almost always has gut dysbiosis. Constipation, in many cases, has gut dysbiosis. If you've been away to, say, the Caribbean or Bali or places like that, and you picked up, some type of a parasite, gut dysbiosis. If you've got inflammatory bowel disease, gut dysbiosis. So it goes along with a whole bunch of different kinds of diseases. However, the subtle and less obvious signs of gut dysbiosis can also be fatigue or just a low lingering tiredness. Brain fog is what I commonly see with gut dysbiosis as a symptom. Now, why does brain fog occur? Well, if you think about it, the healthy bacteria, which are probably lagging in numbers, are not really there sufficiently to produce B vitamins and folate and vitamin K. And these bacteria are also not there to produce the right kinds of antibiotic-like substances like acidophilin, which help to, counter parasites and yeast in the bowel. So these bugs will start taking the upper hand, all right? And they can dig in and they can sit there in these biofilm colonies and play a lot of havoc with you. And they can also produce different types of gases like cadaverine and scatoles and indoles. And these things can get into the bloodstream and create a lot of problems in the head. They can make you feel dull and tired. They can switch off cognitive function. You can't think properly. You're forgetting names. You're getting confused easily. You think you're stoned all the time. It doesn't have to be necessarily a die-off reaction. It can be bad bacteria. Many times when I get a person's gut in great health, all of these cognitive dysfunctions disappear. Their mood improves, their sleep improves, their energy improves. So we call the gut the second brain. So now you can understand why if you want to be a smart person with an upbeat mood, you need to get your gut in great condition. Big link, and it will all come out in future on how incredibly massive the link is between how we feel, think, and how our gut really is. But it goes further. If we haven't got sufficient beneficials, bacteria in our gut, we can also have more inflammation. We can have aches and pains in the body, muscle pains, joint pains. We're certainly going to have a poor immune function because it's estimated that 65% plus of our immunity resides in the first 3 inches of our small intestine. So if we've got very poor levels of beneficials and dysbiosis, it stands to reason we're going to have a higher incidence of acute infectious disease. We're going to have more allergies and hypersensitivities. We're more prone to autoimmune disease. Take your pick, there's about 170 autoimmune diseases. And if we keep getting a disordered gut, we can end up with cancer. And many people now, experts around the world, believe that many cancers originate in dysbiosis toxins, we call endotoxins. So, you know, this video could go on for half an hour. There are so many other signs and symptoms, subtle and obvious ones of dysbiosis, but I think I've painted a reasonable picture for you. So if your gut's playing up, it could well be linked with a lot of the issues that you're facing right now. So let's do something about it. Check out my Candida Crusher program and take a look at my Candida range of dietary supplements, because they were targeted for guys just like you to get rid of this gut dysbiosis and to get you on the path of good health again. Thanks for checking out my video.